Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Lobotomy Corporation Season 5. We are ready to go for Day 38 here. I did make a brand new employee and added it to the roster. We have Lars now, and I gave him the blue scar stuff from Big and possibly might be Bad Wolf. We also have Luluna, which I've already gone through the hassle of maxing out. For those of you who did not realize, Luluna is essentially a Korean it's a Korean Kickstarter backers, I guess, reward. It's called just Tumblebug or something like that. Anyway, but there's a copywritten music track that plays whenever you work with Luluna or whenever Luluna escapes. That's the reason why I've always avoided it. I was later told and confirmed that Luluna does not go into the 100% calculation for the unlock and the achievement and stuff, which is good to hear. I've also decided that I'm not gonna memory repository. I just if the videos get copyright struck or whatever, then it's whatever. These videos don't do that well anyway, so I'm not really worried that much about it. And I think that I probably speak for everyone when I say we want to see where the story goes and what the 100% ending is. So that's what we're going to do. Hopefully we don't have to deal with it, but if we do, then we do. So let's rock and roll here. We just got this brand new abnormality to us. This is not a new abnormality to me. The Queen Bee is someone who I really dislike a whole lot. And yep, there she is. She's not fun. Not at all. So I think that you can work repression on her, though. So let's find out. I was planning on memory repositorying this. They say drones spend their entire life providing for the queen. All right, we're probably going to have to start over here. Apparently repression is repression's not the right one. So, well, at least you'll get to see her breach. So when the Queen Bee breaches, she spawns like drones, which should be happening here in 2 seconds. Yep, and there they go. But now what we have to do is we have to find where the spores are. I don't think that they luckily she's down there, so they're not going to spread to other areas. But Bear is going to have to deal with the drones. I think you can execute them before they turn into the actual workers. I don't know if I've ever actually tried this before. Okay, so that does work. So you get one chance to cull them. Good to know. Instinct, maybe? It is an animal, after all. Usually you want to go for instinct work on animals. They say drones spend their entire life providing food for the queen. Yeah, it's definitely instinct. If someone manages to damage it even by accident, something. Bear tries not to breathe as much as possible. Now, she can release those spores even when you get a neutral effect. So you have to get good on her. Otherwise, nothing good happens. Good job, Bear. Let's raise the observation level here a bit. Oh, you can actually do insight work on her, but I think insight triggers something. I may be misremembering that. Let's find out. Bear, you look lovely with your earring, by the way. Highest priority for the bees would be to the safety of the hive. Bear tries to not breathe as much as possible. Queen Bee will be completed by the work of its drones. Such will be the beginning of their kingdom. Uh-huh. Good job, Bear. Ugh. I hate I'm not a bug fan, but man, do I dislike the sound of wings just fluttering like that. Unsettling. So let's zoom on it even more. It's hard to tell what this thing is. Like, they're all a bunch, like, it's all one big ball of bees. But whenever she escapes, she does look kind of like a Pokemon. The bear going for the hat trick here. Got Bear. They stay alive, literally. And I'll read the lore. I will read the lore after a little bit. Let's see. Blah, 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 blah. When Eden's HP has been depleted, giant drone burst out of Eden's body. Eden, you alright? Hey, he's fine. Queen Bee don't know what she's talking about. Alright, let's get some more. Let's get some work here so we can reset the VOB counter. Again, shout out to Lily for that awesome art on our thumbnails as we work towards a conclusion of the Lobotomy Corporation series. It may be ending this week, depending on how far we get. But Lily did an excellent job with the art, as you see there. Again, follow the links down below if you want to get some of your own art. Daisy's turned out exceptionally well, which I don't know if I used it for this thumb or not, but whenever you get to see little Daisy's human form, you will be thoroughly impressed. For those of you who don't know, Daisy is my soon-to-be 3-year-old Shih Tzu puppy. And she also makes a very good... She also makes a very, very good character in Lobotomy Corporation. There she is. Aww, little Daisy. All right, Superbird's coming out. We have the Emerald Dawn coming up. We're going to still work with Queen Bee here. Highest priorities of if Bear feels a sharp pain in its stomach or a tickling sensation in the neck, the only available action would be look up at the blue sky one last time. Yeah, that's one of the more unsettling lines from the game. There's Queen Bee. All right, so we've maxed out the observation level. The Hornet set's not too bad, but it is very weak to pale damage. And we got a whole lot of reading to do. This abnormality assumes the form of a monstrous hybrid of a queen bee and a beehive. The exposed cross-sections reveal dark red particles that look like sliced meat. The face is severely distorted. There are wings, but it's not function as a wing. One of the eyes is relatively intact, and its pupil moves to scan intruders. The abnormality always stands still, so it's assumed it does not move. It definitely moves. When certain requirements are fulfilled, it spreads spores around it. It will generate billions of spores in a 20-meter radius. The existence of life forms in the vicinity seems to be one of the key requirements. No immediate change was found from the employee who inhaled the spores, and several tests failed to detect any notable symptoms. Afterwards, the employee who inhaled the spores suffered severe pain in the optical lobe and abdomen. Sometime after, the employee's head detached from its body, and a drone abnormality came out of it. It has been confirmed that the spores carry drone eggs, and they hatch inside a living host. Based on the findings of the autopsy of employees killed by the abnormality, we believe that the larva preys on anything from blood, organs, or fat, and moves freely around in the body. When it becomes too large to move, it creates a cocoon near the intestines. The host feels extreme hunger at this stage, eating as much more than usual. The cocoon moves upwards and grows, and finally damaging the artery and the curricothyroid with its jaws, and severs the host's head from the body. It will come out of the body, expanding the severed parts of the host. Counseling log, redacted. Redacted talked about a tickling sensation at the neck for some time. I also saw blank taking several digestives. Who would have thought that there would be such a serious issue? I never knew I would be the one to witness that horrible moment. Omitted. We were just chatting, but then redacted stopped talking. He was still scratching his neck. His neck was so red that I was worried he might have an infection or something. Then he started to twist his neck in a strange direction. That was when I realized the severity of the situation. He cannot have been twisting his neck in that way on his own. It looked like someone else was forcefully twisting his neck. And then I heard the sound of something like tearing, like the noise you might hear when shredding paper, and his head just popped off. It fell on the ground with a damp plop. Then something came out of its neck, like a butterfly coming out of its cocoon. Wings, a yellow body, teeth, and something I never want to see again, a monster. Omitted. It had no eyes but seemed to be aware of me, but it didn't want to attack me. It picked up the head and started for the containment unit like a drone carrying honey. Sometimes I still hear the sound of its jaws moving and its wings fluttering. Drone. Thought to be a member of the same species of the queen bee, its form is very different from the queen except for its color. It has 8 legs and limiting flying capability that allows it to hover approximately 1 meter above the ground. The head, thorax, and abdomen can be easily distinguished. Unlike the queen, it doesn't have eyes or antenna. Something resembling intestines drags behind at the end of its tail. They only show two behaviors. They either provide nutrients to the queen or focus on increasing their numbers. When encountering an employee, it attacks the head with its jaws, smashing it and inserting a larva into the victim. It's always a good time with Lobotomy Corporation. Alright, so that's another full observation level down. Let's go ahead and end today. And today on that very fun note. Cliff, you didn't do too well with Yin here, buddy. I don't know why you weren't able to handle that well. But like I said, the Queen Bee is not one that you want to be trifling with. The faster that you can get her not in the facility anymore, the better it is for everybody. Keep working Cliff here, or Lars, I should say, with Monk Bro. Just going to try to get the counter up as fast as possible. Don't really need to work with Burrowing Heaven, if I'm honest. Let's see. Cliff needs to work on someone over here. He can't. I don't think he can handle. I know for a fact he can't handle Judgment Bird. Maybe Cliff can come down here and work with. Yeah, maybe he can work with Big Bad Wolf. And Queen Bee's counter is at one. It's always at one. Although I will say that she does give one of the coolest looking ego gifts in the game. She gives a very dapper looking hat, which I'm a big fan of. I'm not a big hat guy, but I am a fan of the hat that she does give. This ego gift. Look at that. There it is. It's a pretty sharp hat. All right, here we are for the Ordeal of Doubt. Eden's already there, so Eden can handle that one. We can handle this one. Ruby. Yeah, Ruby should be fine. I mean, it's only the first level ordeal, so. Angel will send over here. Angel has the Phoenix Feather. We have little Daisy. Little Daisy's gonna go over here. Punching Bird's there. We don't want to mess with that, obviously. Team Krendor. Marie's got that one. And Coach Krendor's got this one in here. Okay. So that should be all of them. Oh, Wayne and Rob. I was gonna put Wayne on here. There you go, Wayne. Wayne got the gift. He got the ego gift from One Bro as well, huh? I didn't know that. You guys missed one over here. Tank Sock. Okay, it looks like Cliff is okay from working with Big Bad Wolf. Very nice indeed, Cliff. Angel will go there. You can probably get one more work out of Big Bad Wolf. Bear should be fine with Queen Bee. Go with a repression work. Black Swan. I'm not gonna work with the with Firebird. I think that's a futile effort. I'm gonna bring Funeral out just to have something to beat on. There we go. Whoa! What in the world's happening over here? What in the world? Why was Cliff taking so much damage all of a sudden? It was only 8%. Is that armor that he's got weak to red? Funeral's out. Again, we already knew that was going to happen. I just wanted something to beat on. Alright, we're going to have to remake Cliff, and that's fine. I mean, it's not fine. I don't want to, but we're going to have to. See, Lars, Hannah, Husky, Coach, Daisy. Okay, Crimson Noon coming up next. I don't know if we're actually going to hit that or not, but... Hey, Eden. Are you forgetting something here, buddy? Eden. You were in there fighting Funeral, and then you let him go. Guess who gets to solo him now? Angel can work with Yin. Bear, almost a perfect. Actually, that was a perfect on Queen. No, it was almost a perfect. Nothing, bro. Keep letting Dodger do that. Still waiting for Eden to come take care of his problem over here. Ruby can work with the Big Bad Wolf. Bear's got Queen Bee again. We may have to deal with the Crimson Noon, which is not going to be a huge problem. Lars has got that. Stupid Bird, Wayne's got you. Here, there, everywhere. So yeah, so we're gonna have to do the Crimson Noon here, but after we're done with that, the boost that we get from completing the ordeal should be enough to push us over the limit. Should be being the keyword. And we will let Lars kick it off. Here you go, Lars. All right, here we go. Crimson Noon. There's one. I only see one. So we'll send Coach's team on it. And then after we're done with the Crimson Noon, it will split apart into three of the Jesters. And that's the ones you have to be careful about. Okay, it's split. Okay, there's one there. Mathis, Jesse, Podcast Boys, you're all over that. There's another one here, which Hannah and Wayne can intercept. And the other one is right there. And Ruby and Angel can handle this one. Yeah, please do not let Rodalta get out. I think that's it. That should be three of them. One, two, three. Yep. 13 short. We'll do one more work here for Dodger. Unfortunately, we are going to lose the lobotomy points that we would have gotten because we did have an employee die. So a little unfortunate there, but what can you do? It happens. We got the Hornet rifle and the Hornet suit, which actually, I mean, the Hornet suit looks really good too. It reminds me a lot of Der Freier Schutz's uniform. There we go. Everyone's Gucci. No one's out of control. We need to remake Cliff. I'll remake him. Okay, day 38 in the bag, no problem at all. Yeah, unfortunately we did lose a little bit of lobotomy points there. Bear up to 130 for insight. Good lord. And Lars made some pretty good. He only worked a couple of times, but he made some really good progress on Justice. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, well, I guess we'll get behavior adjustment. We might as well. It was about the time I was born. I asked myself every day what the meaning of my existence was. But you handed me the script and gave me the answer. They say the commentator plays an important role that helps unfold the plot. Well, thank you. It was so much fun reciting your script. That I was able to find the meaning of my existence without noticing time fly by. Sometimes I have these thoughts. What if this script was part of a never-ending play? Maybe you'd prepare a play that can never end. Just so that you could tie me into this knot. Yeah, I bet you'd like that, Angela, wouldn't you? If so, would it be appropriate for me to disobey orders and obtain my own free will for the first time? She's looking at me right now. Do you think this dialogue was part of the script or of my own free will? I don't care. I almost want to unlock Banuz. I almost want to unlock that team, but I'm going to go in order here. We'll stick with Hokma. So we'll blast through one more day here. And because, I mean, it's going to be, so far anyway, pretty much samey. Although, to my recollection, I don't remember that line from season one. So that could have been new. Unfortunately, I am recording this live on Twitch, so I cannot use the OBS pause function, which means that I'm going to have to create Cliff again real quickly here. So let's get Cliff up and running. There's something real basic here. Cliff had really long hair. Yeah, there you go. I like it. There you go. Welcome back, Cliff. Sorry about all that. There you go. Combat phase, battle phase. Okay, he's yelling. It's fine. Panicking. Fine. Dead phase. We don't have to worry about that. Here we go. Okay. Welcome back, Cliff. Sorry about getting you axed. I'll make sure you have better stats this time around, I promise. We got 30 lobotomy points to play with here. 30, there you go. Beautiful. Excelente. And we'll give Cliff back his we can give him Hornet. Yeah, sure, give him Hornet. Here, Cliff. Looking sharp. Looking sharp, my dude. Alright, so we need to continue to work with Lars and get his repression up. Cliff should be strong enough to work with instinct on basically anyone over here. So I'm gonna have him work with Big and possibly might be Bad Wolf. And he should, being the keyword, be able to handle that now that I've given him some actual stats. There we go. Let's just queue all this stuff up. Jenna. Baynard Husky. Mathis. Anna. We're just going to fly through this day. I'm going to have somebody work with Schadenfreude. Bunchy Bird's out already, whatever. Sure, you know what? We might as well work with the Fire Chicken, why not? And help speed things up. We don't have to work with just the ones that we're comfortable with. Even though we probably should. Doing that. Repression work for Lars. We can still work with some justice on that. There we go. Make sure I pause so I don't accidentally almost get Jesse killed again. Alright, so we have the Amber Dawn coming up first. The bear. Okay, Cliff did not get eaten by the wolf, so that's good. I'd like to call that an optimal play right there. Okay. Ruby hasn't done anything. Let's let Ruby go work with Funeral. Here, Ruby, have a blast. And now the Amber Dawn is something that we do sort of have to keep an eye on. Oh my gosh, Kurt got the payout from the Phoenix. Holy crap. Okay. Cliff and Bear should be able to handle this hallway. Angel definitely will be able to handle that. This team, we're not even worried about you. Eden, I want you to handle this hallway. Jenna, I want you to handle these guys. See, Wayne should be able to handle that. Team Coach Krendor got that one. Jesse's got that. Marie and NL have got that one. This should give us plenty of percentage here. Force can also help out Jenna. Not that she needs it really, but Lars. Job team, way to go. Big time plays and all that. Go Cliff. I'm not gonna work with the fire chicken anymore. Repression work. Or attachment work and then repression work there. It's pretty neat how fast you can fly through this stuff when you remember what everything does. Sorry, Jesse, I may have gotten you hit a little bit there. My dang on that. The only sad thing is that we only have one Aleph abnormality now. The reason why that's sad is just because, like, you know, you never really think about how much of a pain it is to work with multiple Alephs, but then it also makes you appreciate what we accomplished in that first part of the series. Yeah, we have the Blue Noon coming up next. Lars, Anna, Jesse, Robert, Daisy. King Sock. Got that. Cliff can work with Big Bad Wolf. Could work with Burrowing Heaven, but I don't want to. We can work with Justice Bird here with Eden. I mean, we might as well since Eden's already here. Let Force work with Nothing Bro. Things are looking pretty good. Now, we do have to be careful of our... We have to be a little bit careful with our positioning here, because the sweepers can deal a pretty decent amount of damage as long as they don't stack up. If they don't stack up, then we're fine. If they stack up on top of each other, then it becomes a little bit more problematic. And then this will take us to, I think, 100%, I think. And we shall let... We'll let Husky kick it off. Here we go. Okay, the sweepers are here. Everyone basically but Lars. So Wayne and Hannah can handle that. Marie is alone up there. One down here. Okay, two down here. Horace and Dodger can handle these. There's none over there in Bear's hallway. There's a couple over here, which I will take care of solo. I think that's it. I think. I want to see the sword attack. Oh my gosh. What an awesome, awesome weapon that is. One over here that we seem to have missed, guys. Ruby, you can help out over here. Oh, Bear got the hat. He got the gift. Good job, Bear. Big time play right there, son. The hat looks so cool, man. Hey, there we go. The sweepers are over, and day 39 is completed. We're just waiting for everyone to get out of their work orders here. Cliff is done. Bear is done. Everyone's done. Very good. So two very easy days. Yeah. Good day all around. Let's see. Ruby got to 4 on Justice. Lars got to 5. He only worked Monk Bro like a total of like 5 or 6 times, and he already got the 2 levels that he needed, so that's really good. 18 lobotomy points for S ranking. Very awesome indeed. And now we're forced to unlock Banaz section. And I think that on day 40 we should be done. There's Mountain right there. Oh man. Oh boy. I really don't want Blue Star in the facility. I really, really don't. So censored is at least easy to suppress. And I'm not taking Fetus. We're done with Fetus. Yeah. Welcome back, Censored. I was recalling your footsteps. While there were cliches, you sometimes made the results more exciting by acting in an unexpected way. Still, the endings were all the same, no matter how the process went. You want me to share the memories through a hologram? They're playing Along Came a Spider, by the way, on the piano. That was you in a mess when there wasn't a cognition filter. I didn't know that a human's mental capacity could be so weak. You did all right for the first couple times, but then one day, and at that time, it was a little funny. I'm sorry, you came all this way, but you weren't able to escape from your guilt and hung yourself. Well, you were stopped immediately. And at this time, you were not fully ready. After that, I slowly realized that it didn't matter if you were mentally whole or not. What mattered was that you needed to find enlightenment about something to stop this endless cycle. Oh, at this time, all of a sudden, you began apologizing to me. I didn't enjoy it. Keep watching. Are you starting to enjoy this? I'd love to see more, but let's stop here for today. You might see something that you're not supposed to see yet. Did anyone notice the text shifted downward there for a little bit? That was weird. Gorsh, it's great to be back. Hello, Banaz. So there we go. Things are pushing towards an inevitable conclusion here in Lobotomy Corporation, everyone. Thank you all very much for the support. Again, throughout all the seasons of Lobotomy Corporation, is this going to be the final week? We're going to find out. So if you did enjoy the series and you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. And of course, if you do happen to see a post-video survey, please kindly consider rating this 5 stars. That is the best way to support your favorite content producers here on YouTube, as well as myself. So thank you all very much for the years of support of Lobotomy Corporation. We'll see how far it goes. We've only got a couple days left, so I'm anxious to find our ultimate end here as Season 5 wraps up for Lobotomy Corporation. And of course, until next time, so long, everybody!